ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సో మ్యాగ్నెటిజం అండ్ మ్యాటర్ చాప్టర్ కంప్లీటెడ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ అ ప్రాబ్లమ్ సార్ సమ్ వాట్ ఈజీ యూ హ్యావ్ టు డూ దిస్ మ్యాగ్నెటిజం అండ్ మ్యాటర్ టాపిక్ ఈజ్ సేమ్ యాజ్ దట్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రిక్ చార్జెస్ అండ్ ఫీల్డ్స్. సో ద కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ టూ electric charges and fields and magnetism and matter are combined, so that is the new chapter. So that is moving charges and magnetism, moving charges and magnetism, next chapter. So the combination of electric field and magnetic field, so that is moving charges. So that means here the concept is moving charges produces magnetic field, moving charges produces magnetic field. So that is the main course of this chapter. But varying magnetic field also produces electric field, varying magnetic field also produces magnetic field. That is one more chapter, electromagnetic induction, electromagnetic induction. So generally till now we discussed about magnets produces magnetic field, charges produces electric field, charges are in motion produces electric current, but charges are in motion also produces, charges are in motion also produces magnetic field, charges are in also, charges are in motion also produces magnetic field also. So that's we are going to discuss about. Main thing is only one side we are discussing, charges are in motion produces magnetic field, this converse or variable magnetic field also produces electric field. So this topic we can discuss in the next one, that is electromagnetic induction. Now we are discussing in the first way, next second way, reverse. So first, how can we prove that moving charges produces magnetic field, moving charges produces magnetic field. So here this must be experienced by the scientist named Oersted, this must be experienced by the scientist named Oersted. What is meant by the scientist name, how he conclude that means. So for example, let us say it is the magnetic needle, this magnetic needle, so consists of north pole and south pole. Let us say this is the current carrying conductor, this is the current carrying conductor. How the current flowing through the wire, how the current flowing through the wire, so due to the motion of the electrons, due to the motion of the electrons current flows through the conductor, due to the motion of the electrons current flows through the conductor. So electrons, that means charges, charges are in motion produces magnetic field, that's we are discussing. So current flowing through the conductor, so for example the current flowing from like this, current flows like this, due to the flow of current the needle must shows deflection. When the magnetic needle shows deflection, when the magnetic needle placed in the magnetic field, then only it shows deflection. If there is no magnetic field, the needle does not shows any deflection. If there is no any magnetic field, if there is no magnetic field, the needle shows no deflection. But here the needle shows deflection, here the needle shows deflection. How the needle, why the needle shows deflection? Because of the magnetic field. How this magnetic field comes from? Due to the motion of the charged particles in a conductor, due to the motion of the charged particles in a conductor, due to that motion what happens, due to that motion magnetic field exists. So that means that is the situation. If the direction of the current reversed, if the direction of the current reversed, the deflection shown by the needle also reversed. For example, here the current flows in this direction from left to right. If the direction of the current is reversed, let us say this is the direction of the current is reversed, that the deflection shown by the needle also reversed. So that is the best example, that is the best proof of presence of magnetic field due to the flow of the charged particles. This is the magnetic needle. When the magnetic needle shows deflection because of any existence of the magnetic field, then only it shows deflection. When how this magnetic field exists, how this magnetic field exists due to the flow of charged particles in a conductor. So that is called current. Flow of charged particles is called current. So that is the situation. So this is the best experiment. So that means, so for example, best example to find out the direction of the current is, so direction of the magnetic field is, for example, if the current flows in this direction, curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the current. Here they stretch your right hand thumb rule. By using right hand thumb rule, we can decide this. So curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the current, and this thumb indicates the direction of the magnetic field, and this thumb indicates the direction of the magnetic field, or this thumb indicates the direction of flow of current, this thumb indicates the direction of flow of current, and curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Both are correct. If the current flowing in the direction only right hand, by using only right hand thumb rule, we can do anything direction based on direction. Don't flow, don't use the swimming rule like this, all rules. Forget about this. Forget about that. Only we must remember one, that is right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule. How the direction of the current or direction of the magnetic field can be calculated with the help of direction, right hand thumb rule. See here, simple things, very clear it is. If the curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the current, curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the current, and the thumb indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Or if the curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the magnetic field, thumb indicates the direction of the current. So flow of current is important here. If the current flow in the form of circles or straight line, if the current flows straight line here, if the current flows in the straight conductor, the direction of the magnetic field is, curling of the fingers indicates the direction of the magnetic field. So main thing, so right hand the Fleming right hand thumb rule only. Right hand thumb rule. So two conditions exist here. To find out the direction of the magnetic field, to find out the direction of the magnetic field, we must use right hand thumb rule. What is that? First one is, if the current flows in the straight conductor, if the current flows in the straight conductor like this, stretch your thumb in the direction of currents, stretch your thumb in the direction of currents, curling of the fingers indicates indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Curling of the fingers indicates the direction of magnetic field. See here, so this is the direction of the current, stretch your thumb, and above the conductor, let us say this, the curling of the fingers above the conductor, the direction of the magnetic field is outwards, and below the conductor, direction of the magnetic field inwards. That means above the conductor and below the conductor, the direction of the magnetic field must be in opposite direction. Above the conductor and below the conductor, the direction of the magnetic field must be in opposite direction. See here, curling of the fingers. See here, this is the thumb. Thumb indicates the direction of the current. Above the fingers, what is the direction of curling of the fingers? This is outwards. Curling of the fingers is outwards. But below the conductor, what is the direction of the fingers? Inwards. So therefore, above and below the conductor, definitely the direction of the magnetic field must be in opposite direction. So second condition here, if the current flowing in closed loops so in this situation curling of fingers indicates the direction of current. Curling of the finger indicates the direction of current. Thumb indicates the direction of magnetic field. Thumb indicates the direction of magnetic field. So this is the two we have to do, two points we have to remember. These are the two rules. Whatever is the direction of the flow of current, in a straight way or curling way, anyway we can find out the direction of the magnetic field. It flows in the direction of the straight way, curling of the finger indicates the magnetic field. If the current flows in the direction of the circles, or that means in the direction of the curling of the fingers, thumb indicates magnetic field. So for example, this is the curling of the fingers. What is the direction? It is anti-clockwise. So what is the direction of the thumb? Upwards. That means the direction of the magnetic field upwards. If the current flowing in this direction clockwise, what is the direction of the thumb? Inwards. So that means in both the situation the magnetic field is in opposite direction. So that is the two rules you must remember. Only based on these two we can calculate direction of the magnet. Direction, the direction is very important, because magnetic field is vector and electric field is also a vector quantity. The direction is very, very important here. So this is right hand thumb rule. Next. So this is the origin of the magnetic field due to the flow of charged particles. So that means a magnetic needle is placed nearer to the current carrying conductor, then definitely it shows deflection. If the direction of the current reversed, the deflection of the magnetic needle also reversed. So based on how can we calculate the direction of the magnetic field? So these are the two rules. You must follow these two. Don't follow any otherwise. So very easy, these two are. Don't get confused. So next, before we go into that, last one rings, Fleming's left hand rule. So Fleming's left hand rule. So Fleming's left hand rule means this is the left hand, and stretch your thumb, forefinger and central finger in mutually perpendicular directions. Thumb, forefinger and central finger arranged in mutually perpendicular directions. In this, the central finger indicates the direction of motion of the charged particle, and this forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, and thumb indicates the direction of the force. That is Fleming's left hand rule. Stretch your left hand, stretch your three fingers, so that is thumb, forefinger and central finger, in three mutually perpendicular directions. like this. So these three fingers indicates three different. Central finger indicates the direction of motion of the charged particle, and forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, and the thumb indicates the direction of the force. So Fleming's left hand rule. So thumb, forefinger, and a central finger. Stretch your thumb, forefinger, central finger of the left hand in mutually perpendicular directions. Stretch your thumb, forefinger, and central finger of the left hand in mutually perpendicular directions. And this first central finger indicates direction of motion of charged particle. Forefinger indicates so the direction of the magnetic field. Next, thumb. So the direction of force acting on charged particle. So stretch your thumb, forefinger, central finger of the left hand in mutually perpendicular direction. The central finger indicates the direction of motion of the charged particle, and forefinger indicates the direction of magnetic field, and the thumb indicates the direction of the force acting on the charged particle. Here one more you have to remember. This is Fleming's left hand rule. You must remember this, very important. While calculating the force acting on the charge, if the charged particle enters into the magnetic field, how can you calculate the force and how can you calculate the direction of the force? So that is the thing. So next, here let us say this symbol indicates the magnetic field is acting into the board. Into symbol indicates the direction of the magnetic field is into the paper or into the board, like this, into the board. And one more thing is, this indicates the direction of the magnetic field is out of the board. Into indicates, cross marks indicates the direction of the magnetic field is inwards, and this indicates the direction of the magnetic field is outwards. This is inwards and this is outwards. So that is the Fleming's left hand rule. And next, we can discuss about force experienced by the charged particle in magnetic field. So that is the condition, force experienced by the charged particle in magnetic field. if the charged particle enters into the magnetic field, what is the force experienced by that? That's we have to calculate now. So now, here, if a charged particle of charge Q enters into the magnetic field, enters into the magnetic field B bar with velocity V bar. If a charged particle of charge Q enters into the magnetic field B bar with velocity V bar, the force experienced by the force experienced by the charged particle is, we can write it as F bar is equals to Q into V bar cross B bar. That is the force experienced. F bar is equals to Q into V bar cross B bar. The cross product of velocity vector and magnetic field vector. The cross product of velocity vector and magnetic field vector. F bar is equals to Q into V bar cross B bar. So from this, so here according to cross product definition, so the direction of force is perpendicular to both V bar and B bar. According to the definition of cross product, the direction of the force is perpendicular to both V bar and B bar. The cross product of two vectors is a vector. What is the direction of the vector? The direction of the vector is always perpendicular to the plane containing the remaining two vectors. So that is, the direction of F is perpendicular to both V bar and B bar. So by according to magnitude of F can be written as VB sin theta. Simply F can be written as BQV sin theta. This is the magnitude of force. F is equals to BQV sin theta. What is B? Magnetic field. What is Q? Charge of the charged particle. What is V? Velocity of the charged particle. So F is equals to BQV sin theta. So this is the force experienced by the charged particle when it enters into the magnetic field. So now, if theta is equals to 0 or 180, if theta is equals to 0 degrees or 180 degrees, that means if the charged particle enters in the direction of the magnetic field or opposite, what is theta? Here, theta is angle between V bar and B bar. That is, theta is the angle between V bar and B bar. So that means if theta equals to 0 or 180, so that means if the charged particle, so the charged particle enters in the direction of, in the direction or opposite to the direction of the field, the direction or opposite to the direction of the field, then F must be 0. There is no force experienced by the charged particle. When this situation, theta equals to 0 or 180, that means if the charged particle enters in the direction or opposite to the direction of the field, in the direction or opposite to the direction of the field, then F equals to 0. In the same way, if theta is equals to 90, theta equals to 90, then F is equals to BQV. This is the maximum amount of force acts on the charged particle. F equals to BQB. This is the maximum force. When this situation, if the charged particle enters normal to the magnetic field or perpendicular to the magnetic field, it's like that. So this is the force experienced by the charged particle in magnetic field. F is equals to Q into V bar cross B bar. So that is F equals to BQB sin theta. Next. So next situation, next application, here it is, come to the topic. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. For example, a charged particle with charge q enters into the magnetic field with velocity v. This is the direction of the into marks indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Into in the sense, the direction of the magnetic field is inwards. Now if the charged particle enters normal to the magnetic field horizontally. So magnetic field is acting inwards, but the charged particle is enters horizontally. According to Fleming's left hand rule, previously we discussed already, what is the force, what is the direction of the force experienced by the magnetic field? So this is the direction of the magnetic field, and central finger indicates the direction of motion of the charged particle, and this thumb indicates the direction of the force. What is the direction? That means this charged particle must be deviates the path through this. Now after deviation, again this is the direction of the magnetic field, and central finger indicates the direction of the charged particle, and the thumb indicates the direction of the force. And what is the direction of the force again here? Is like this. So that means if the charged particle enters normal to the magnetic field, then it experiences what is that? Circular path. See here, first situation. Initially the charged particle enters like this, and this is the direction of the magnetic field. What is the direction of the force? Thumb indicates the direction of the force. What is the direction of the thumb? Upwards. So the charged particle deflects upward direction. Once the charged particle deflects upward direction, now this is the magnetic field, forefinger, and central finger indicates the direction of the charged particle. Then again, what is the direction of the force? Outwards, like this. So if the charged particle enters, normal to the magnetic field, what happens? It experiences circular path. If the charged particle enters normal to the magnetic field, then it experiences circular path. So circular path means, so magnetic force supplies necessary centripetal force. So if anybody to perform circular path, the what is the force necessary for that? Centripetal force. Where that centripetal force comes from here? Due to the magnetic force, that centripetal force exists. So that is BQV is equals to mv square by r. Magnetic force, big V, because it enters normal to the magnetic field. Normal in the sense, theta is 90. Then the force is BQV. So, BQV is equals to V, 1V cancel. BQ is equals to MV by R. So, R can be written as MV by BQ. What is the R here? Radius of the circular path. Radius of the circular path. R is equals to MV by BQ. R is equals to MV by BQ. Therefore, R is equals to, what is R here? Radius of the circular path. Radius of the circular path. R, momentum of the particle in that situation. Momentum of the charged particle. So, MV is equals to, so BQR. So, MV can be written as BQR, momentum of the charged particle. Then, velocity can be written as from this BQR by M. Velocity can be written as V is equals to BQR by M. So, this is the velocity of the charged particle. And this is the momentum of the charged particle and radius of the charged particle MV by BQ. Next here, angular velocity. So, it experiences circular path. What is the angular velocity? So, from this V can be written as R omega. So, that is BQR by M. RR gets cancelled. Omega can be written as BQ by M. Angular velocity of the charged particle. What is angular velocity? We know R omega equals to BQR by M. RR gets cancelled. Omega equals to BQ by M. So, here from this we can write angular velocity does not depends on radius. Angular velocity does not depends on radius, because omega equals to BQ by M, there is no radius term here, there is no radius term. Therefore, angular velocity does not depends on radius, does not depends on radius. Now, frequency or time period, now we can calculate frequency and time period. So, omega is equals to, we know, BQ by M. Time period 2 pi by t can be written as bq by m. So, t can be written as 2 pi m by bq. Here the time period also does not depends on, time period does not depends on speed, does not depends on radius. Time period does not depends on, does not depends on speed and radius of circular path. T is equals to 2 pi m by bq. M is the mass of the charged particle. B is the magnetic field. Q is the charge. So, that is why time period does not depends on speed and radius. So, frequency can be written as reciprocal of time period. So, that is bq by 2 pi m. So, here the frequency also does not depends on the speed and radius. Time period does not depends on speed and radius, and frequency also does not depends on speed and radius. So, this is the situation. When a charged particle enters normal to the magnetic field, what happens? The charged particles must experience circular path. To perform circular path, what is the force necessary for that centripetal force? Where that centripetal force comes from due to the magnetic force. So, that is why we are equating BQ is equals to MV square by R. How can we decide that that is the circular path? Based on Fleming's left hand rule. Based on Fleming's left hand rule, we can decide that the path is circular path. So, that is the situation here. Of course, in this, here. So during the path of the charged particle, speed remains constant, but velocity changes. Speed of the charged particle remains constant, but velocity changes. What? Speed constant, velocity changes. How the velocity changes here? If the charged particle enters like this, due to the force, the charged particle, direction of the charged particle becomes circular. That means continuously the direction of the charged particle changes. If the direction changes, velocity changes. If the direction of the charged particle changes, velocity also changes. But speed is a scalar. It's having only magnitude. The magnitude of the velocity remains constant, but the direction of the velocity continuously changes. Direction of the charged particle changes. That's why velocity changes. Speed remains constant. And one more point, important point is, the work done by the force, the work done by the magnetic force. What is that force? Magnetic force. Work done by the magnetic force on charged particle is zero. So, work done by the magnetic force on the charged particle is zero. Why the work done is zero? See here, this is the magnetic field and this is the charged particle enters. So this is the motion of the charged particle. But what is the direction of the force? Upwards. This motion of the charged particle and the direction of the force must be in opposite direction. Force and displacement are mutually perpendicular. So generally, work done formula is F S cos theta. Here, see here, this is the direction of motion of the charged particle, but the thumb indicates the direction of the force. What is the angle between the force and the direction of motion? 90 degrees. So that's why theta is equals to 90. Therefore, work done is equals to F S cos 90. Therefore, work done must be zero. Work done by the magnetic force on the charged particle must be zero. So, work done is zero. That means kinetic energy of the charged particle remains constant. Kinetic energy does not changes, because work done equals to change in kinetic energy. If the work done is zero, kinetic energy remains constant. That is the points regarding this charged particle, motion of the charged particle in the magnetic field. So like this. So these are the key points in this, theoretical points. And problematic, we can use those formulas, but in theoretical points. What is the kinetic energy of the charged particle? So kinetic energy is equals to, you can write P square by 2m. What is P? Momentum. So that is bqr whole square by 2m. So that is b square q square r square by 2m. This is the kinetic energy of the charged particle. Kinetic energy of the charged particle. Or according to this, kinetic energy also can be written as EV or QV. So b square q square r square by 2m, where V is potential difference. V is the potential difference. According to definition of the potential, work done is nothing but Vq, we can write. So potential, so V can be written as B square Q R square by 2m. like this. So this is the kinetic energy of the charged particle in that, like that. So this is the topic here.